was kind of happening again, but is there any way to kind of pinpoint what's happening between the first half and the second half?
Lack of execution. That's all I see. That's all I notice. We had chances in the Alabama game. We came down to fourth down, third and ones, short yard situations, and they stuffed us. And if we execute, who knows where the drive will go. And the defense stayed on the field too long, second half. Got to keep them on the field. But Alabama executed, we didn't, and the results were no points.
When you go into halftime and you played in Alabama and you're tied with them, do you feel good? I mean, is there momentum that's been built up from that first half that you think is going to carry to the second half?
It was, but as you know, it's not going to carry over unless you're locked in on your assignment and you're ready to execute and as best as we can. And we didn't do that. We failed to do that as an offense, and we didn't score points. And Coach talked about it yesterday. He said in these big games, with like something like 50, we getting outscored 58-0 in the second half or something like that. But and I was like, wow, that's unreal. And you're not going to win like that. And if we don't play in the second half, we're not going to win football games because it's not going to get any easier.
You guys went through a similar stretch last year with these second half struggles. Is there anything different about it compared to last year? Is it just different mistakes or is it the same exact thing?
Feels like deja vu to me. It's the same exact thing, same exact results. Got some tough breaks. Lost a couple of guys. It's very unexpected. But just got to keep pushing forward, keep trucking, and keep leading this football team. Have great leadership as best as we can.
Tauren, is there scheme things or are the opponents doing stuff substantially different in the second half against you defensively than what you saw in the first half, or is it, do you think it's just execution and mindset?
It's definitely execution and mindset with us. We're a very youthful football team, and like Coach said, very frail. That's the smallest thing that affects us, and we can't have that. Things not going to go our way in the football game, and we gotta continue to move forward. We have bad breaks, and bad breaks are going to happen. It's football. It's not a perfect football game. And we got to continue to do that. And we got to realize that we have to play four quarters of football in order to win in this league.
Is there more pressure, you think, in the second half? I mean, you guys had bad breaks in the first half. I mean, you punted Saturday night, overcame that. And, you know, it wasn't like it was everything went perfect in the first half. Do you think you guys feel more pressure in the second half? Because you know, there is no halftime coming up. It's the end of the game. Is that why you're more fragile in the second half than the first half?
I don't feel any pressure. And that's probably because I'm an older guy, and I'm ready to go out there just like it's the first half. But then that's just me. Can't be one guy. And I got to continue to communicate. And like I said, it's lack of execution. Coaches are putting us in the best situations. Players on the field got to execute and stay locked in on their assignment.
Or were you guys surprised to see Worley go in at all?
Nah. It's not going the way it should be a quarterback at the quarterback position. And, you know, I know Coach is going to make the best decision for this football team. And right now, that's clearly.
What do you guys see out of him in practice? I mean, we see him throw a little bit, but what about him, you know, stands out to you?
Well, I just feel like he's confident and he wants to play. We were talking yesterday. I asked him, was he ready to go? And he just looked at me and was like, yes, sir. And I don't know why he called me sir, but he was just like, yes, sir. And I was like, well, just we're here for you. I believe in you 100%. I know these coaches believe in you because if they didn't, they wouldn't put you as a quarterback. So, you know, it's great. It's great to see. You know, hopefully it'll help us. It's the same situation Bray was in. I was talking to Bray as well. I was like, it's the same situation you was in. He got thrown in there. You know, it didn't go great at first, but he got through a couple of breaks and started playing well.
Does that shake your confidence at all if your quarterback is calling you sir?
I just looked at him like, why don't you call me sir? You know, he's a young guy. He probably didn't even think about it. But, I'm confident in him. You know, hopefully he does well.
Is that frustrating now halfway through your senior year and this is kind of deja vu, as you said, with Bray now trying to get used to another quarterback?
I think this entire season is frustrating for me, to say the least. I definitely didn't expect to be in the position that we're in. But we are, and I can't change anything. All I can change is my attitude and how I approach the practice field. And I talked to a couple of the seniors, and, you know, we were talking about this. We definitely didn't expect to be where we're at, but we are. And can't change the situation, but we can't change what happens from here on out.
How much better did Alex Spiller play at the center position, and were you surprised for a kid who hasn't played in a position at all, or that he did so well?
Yeah, he did great. And before the game, he was like, man, I'm kind of nervous to play center. And I'm like, oh, my God. Playing Alabama, number two team in the country, and you're telling me you're nervous. But he did great. Coach, he's saying put them guys in the best situation to be successful in the run game and the pass game. And we just got to protect the quarterback and continue to move the ball and score points, things we're not doing. So we have to continue to score points.
Tauren, a lot's been made about halftime adjustments or lack thereof. Can you kind of just like take us through, you know, when you sit down at halftime, you know, what you guys do and how those adjustments are made?
Well, Coach Haney comes up and just tells us what the defense is giving us and what we'll do to kind of just thrive off what the defense is giving us. And wherever we go, we see it. We know what we're going to do. We're confident in what we're going to do. And then we go on the field and three and out. You know, every single time we had the ball three possessions and three and out. And can't have that on teams like that. And you just can't have it. A great football team, they're gonna thrive off that and they're going to produce off that. And they did. They scored on each drive that we did not score. So, you know, that's on offense. And I told those guys that we have to score points. And I told them on the field that we have to score points. You got to keep the defense off the field with the offense, with a running back like Trent, and with receivers making plays like they were. And we didn't make the plays. I didn't make the plays that we were supposed to make in order to score points on Alabama.
Tauren, is it harder to make halftime adjustments with younger players?
I think that's a coach's question. That's kind of loaded. I can't answer that, but I'm sure it is. I'm sure it's tough. You know, young guys don't know what to expect as older guys would, older experienced guys. But, I mean, I'm sure it is.
One more.